The Western Region annual CEO meeting held in Barara City attracted savers from different districts. In his speech, the NSSF Managing Director, Patrick Ayota, explained that the overall benefits paid out to eligible members during that period generally increased, albeit by 1%, from 1.189 trillion shillings in the financial year 2021 to 2022 to 1.199 trillion shillings in 2022-2023. Ayota cautioned people against using bad means to access the NSSF money.
Sometimes because of problems and so on, people try to come up with all kinds of ways to get access. Sometimes they try to access other people's money. Sometimes they try to access their own money, but for their eligible. So one thing that we found out happening in two areas which are very interesting is on exempt employment, where somebody claims he has left the private sector and gone to the public sector. And because, say, the local government, the police, the army, they have their own pension scheme, they can take their money from NSSF. We found that to be an area where a lot of people try to see if they can get the money to the access. We find a manager from a very prominent company going to a local government, and then he has a title called office messenger. When you follow it up, you find that he hired somebody to replace him there so he could get access to his money. What has been very interesting of late is where people claim they died. And you find there's connivance between the family members so they can report this person is dead. But when you follow up, you find they're still alive. So those are the things that we are seeing happening, especially among our members as they try to access their money, maybe due to problems they may have.
Ayota added that the fund has generally posted a remarkable performance on almost all key performance indicators, despite a challenging environment characterized by turmoil in Europe due to the Russia-Ukraine war. He assured Ugandans that their money is safe with entities and encouraged them to attract more savers.
Our goal going forward is to have more and more Ugandans saved so we can own this piece of what we call NSSF.
Regarding compliance in the Western Region, information from the fund indicated that Western Region had the lowest compliance rate of 48% compared to other regions. David Mwesigwa, a senior manager mandatory business in NSSF, urged the employers to remit social security contributions for their workers and avoid penalties.
The retainer has the basic pay. So whatever is added as allowance adds to the gross pay. So whatever the doctor earns as allowance plus the retainer is what makes the gross pay. This is where the 5% and the 10% is subjective.
Meanwhile, the savers tasked NSSF to also think about investing in regions. In his response, Ayota said plans are underway to ensure programs benefit all savers in all regions.
Because of cost figures in independence is percent, now I'm asking, I want to know, am I supposed to also deduct 15% on the retainer fee?
We are going to build houses for the low-end savers, which will come at 200 million. How long will it take this person, this 83%, who is below 10 million, to access that?
Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news in Barara City.